Hey guys, welcome to Sunbell Studios. Today we'll be discussing The Little Things, right now on theaters and HBO Max. The story revolves around two police officers, played by Denzel Washington and Rami Malek. They're chasing after a serial killer suspect, played by Jared Leto. It explores the psychological trauma of detectives dealing with homicides day in and day out. As usual, we're gonna rate this on our notepad and reveal it to you at the end of the video. All right, ready to discuss. The relationship between Joe, who's played by Denzel Washington, and Jimmy, who's played by Rami Malek, is very unique. You have this older cop who is basically asked by this young new detective to come back and look at horrific scenes because he needs his expertise and he needs that perspective that Joe is able to provide. He sees things from a different angle and he's able to put himself in the victim's shoes as well as the suspect's shoes. Yeah, from the very beginning of the movie, they really dive deep into Joe's character. We know he has more of an old school type of approach to investigating homicide. They even compare him to Columbo, which if you know, it's like a 70s series on detectives. And they say that he has an unusual style. As opposed to the younger cop, Jimmy, Joe goes by his instincts. Mm-hmm. He's got a lot of experience. Part of what makes Joe so good is that he really tries to understand the victims. The homicide victims. They may be dead people, but he doesn't see them as so. He even talks to them. He understands what, you know, what they're like, what their last meal was. And he really believes that it's the little things that get you caught. And because of that experience and wealth of knowledge and him focusing on the small details that's very easy to miss, he gets consumed by these cases, right? Mm-hmm. And he's trying to protect Jimmy, the new up-and-coming detective, from becoming who he was when he was in that role. In fact, the younger cop, Jimmy, he gets into some issues, and it's Joe that could really help him through it, and only Joe that would fully understand and help him through this issue. This movie shows that the protagonist is not always black and white. There's some gray areas. In fact, it shows that there's actually a lot of similarities between the detectives and the murder suspect. Yeah, like the obsession with the case, the unending determination to get closure. And I think it deals with mental insanity that obsession can lead to. All right, it's time to reveal our ratings. Are you ready?
Yes.
On a count of three. One, two. Wow, I thought you'd rate it way higher than that.
Yeah, I'm surprised too because I love true crime.
Oh like, yeah, you're listening to podcasts all the time on crime.
Yeah, I'm a true crime fanatic for sure, but I gave it a 6 for a couple of reasons. First, I thought a couple of the scenes were very unrealistic. Like, they just wouldn't happen in real life. And like at one point, the suspect is basically dragging the detective out, making him do certain things, without spoilers, making him do certain things that a detective with any kind of intelligence would not do. Maybe he would, but in this case, in this scenario, I just don't think it's, I think it's pretty far-fetched.
You know, I do know what moment you're talking about, and that's what I thought as well. I was thinking, what is going on? This is so unrealistic and out of character. But then I was thinking more, and I think the reason why he did it is because he's so determined to figure this case out. He would do anything to do it, and he had total trust in his partner.
Yeah, but how is the suspect always two steps ahead of the detective throughout the entire movie?
I mean, that's not so unrealistic, isn't it? I mean, you're the true crime junkie. Isn't it true that most crimes don't get solved?
Good point. And my last point, I don't like how the movie ended. I felt like I didn't receive the closure that I was looking for. I had so many questions at the end. I'm just the type of person that likes closure.
I think it actually did have closure. I thought there was just enough there to give the audience an idea of what happened. It might have not been in your face, but it's kind of like Shutter Island, where it's just enough for you to piece together what you think happened.
Let us know what you think about the movie. Did you like it? Have you even seen it? Are you going to see it?
If you enjoyed this, please don't forget to like, subscribe, share with your friends, and follow us on our Instagram, Sunbell Studios. Thanks!
Bye!